You might be wondering, what exactly is a database? Well, think of it as a big filing cabinet where all your information is organized and is stored, so a computer server can easily access and use it. Today's tutorial is going to be about creating a database in PostgreSQL. Now let's learn how to create a database in PostgreSQL. Towards the end of this video, I will show you some handy backslash commands that you can use. So let's get started. To create a database in PostgreSQL, we use create database SQL command. Right on your screen is the syntax of the create database DDL. Now I will explain each of this parameter to you. Like usual, the statement starts with the reserve phrase create database, followed by the name of the database. This name could be of your choice. Then we have the keyword owner. Using it, you specify the username who will own this database. By default, the user who executes the create database is the owner of the tablespace. By owner, I mean the user who has full administrative control over the database. Then we have template. Using this keyword, you can specify a template database that will be used for creating this database. By default, Postgres uses template one database. This helps the server to quickly create a new database with a predefined structure. Then we have encoding. Using this keyword, you specify the character set for your database. LC collate. LC collate stands for locale collation. Using it, you set the collation order for the new database. Means this parameter refers to the rules that determines the way text is stored in a database. For example, if LC collate is set to English, then similar to English language dictionary, the word cherry, banana and apple will be stored alphabetically and is stored as apple, banana and cherry. But if LC collate is set to some other language, then these words will be stored differently. If you omit this parameter, then by default it will get LC collate value from the template used by the database. LC type. LC type stands for locale character classification. This parameter determines how the character, and by character I means letters, numbers, symbols, etc., etc., are categorized in the database. For example, if LC type is set to English, then the letters A, E, I, O, and U will be classified as vowels. But if LC type is set to Spanish, then these letters will be classified differently. Tablespace. Using this clause, you can set the new tablespace where the files of your new database will be stored on the disk. As tablespace is a location on the disk where a database is stored its data. That being said, let's create a new database. First, I will connect to my PostgreSQL container on Docker. In my previous video, I demonstrated the process of connecting to PostgreSQL. And you can find the link to that video on your screen and in the description. Now I am successfully connected to PostgreSQL. Let's clear the screen. Done. Next, let's utilize the syntax I just presented to create a database. Using the syntax I showed you earlier, I am creating this database. The name of this database is library. It is owned by the user Postgres. Postgres is the default user that has been created during the installation. We will learn how to create a new user in the future tutorials. Then we have template, and this database is based on template 0 template. In encoding, we have used UTF-8, which is a Unicode standard. This is widely used standard for representing text in the computer. In LC collate and LC type, I have set locale collation and character classification to en_us.utf8. This is a locale which represents English using UTF-8 encoding. In the end, the tablespace used is ts underscore users. This is the same tablespace which we created in the last tutorial. Let's execute. Done. Our database library created successfully.
As I promised earlier, it's time to explore some helpful backslash commands. Let's check out.
Let's clear the screen. Great. In PostgreSQL, you can see all the databases that have been created by using a simple meta command, and that is backslash L. In PostgreSQL, commands that starts with backslash are called meta commands, and backslash L is one of those meta commands which will show all the databases that are created. Let's execute. Here is the database library that we just created. To connect with the database library, we will use the backslash c meta command like this. Backslash c followed by the name of the database, which is library. Let's execute. Now we are connected with the database library. If you want to check the current database with which you are currently connected, then you can do so with the help of a very simple select statement like this. Let's execute. And we are currently connected with the library database.
And that concludes our video. If you enjoyed it, show your support by giving it a thumbs up and hitting that subscribe button. Oh, and don't forget to turn on notification by pressing the bell icon. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com signing off. Stay curious and keep exploring.